What you are about to see are 3 days, 72 hours of history of the Chicago Fire Department. Some consider it the busiest 72 hours the Chicago Fire Department ever had. It started November 12, 1964 at 12:49 p.m., 2455 South Michigan Avenue, a vacant four-story brick building. Within minutes, 1:43 p.m. to be exact, 5:11 and 3 specials. 60-mile-an-hour winds didn't help. 200-plus Chicago firemen on the scene. 45 pieces of equipment fought the fire. On the scene, Chicago Fire Commissioner Robert J. Quinn. Fire Commissioner Quinn was asked what was the cause of the fire. Fire Commissioner Quinn also had some other comments that he wished to make.
Well, they're demolishing most of these buildings here, and like all of them, we don't know. We're trying to find out, and we're going to find out about this one. The thing that we're concerned with is the possibility of a fire like this getting away, and then giving the city of Chicago something to think about.
The pictures you are seeing were shot on 16-millimeter movie film. They've been transferred to videotape subsequently, just so that's an explanation as to the change in the quality that you'll see later on. The high winds at this fire caused embers to go about four blocks away. 357 East 24th Street, a three-story building. They picked up equipment from wherever they could find. Basically, another 211 alarm response. Once again, that 60-mile-an-hour wind was one of the main problems that Chicago firemen had to deal with the first day of what we said would be 72 hours of much, much work. The embers that we spoke about before have now caused this fire. This is the fire on East 24th Street. As you can see, it's well involved in fire. They were picking up equipment from the first fire and from other places in the city of Chicago to get to this scene. In case you're wondering, one of the problems in shooting pictures out of a helicopter, that 60-mile-an-hour wind is just as difficult to hold a helicopter still as you see trying to fight the fire. In those days, the Chicago Fire Department had the civilian defense, men and women that worked at major fires. That's the reason for those coats that you saw a few moments ago. Eight firemen were injured in this fire, none serious. All the residents in the building got out safely. It's 5:08 p.m., November 13th, a warehouse, 40th and South Kedzie, the Goldblatt's warehouse complex, reportedly 350 by 600 feet, 1 million cubic feet in size. No fire walls. fire basically confined at this time to the basement. 4 hours later, that fire was then escalated to a 411 alarm fire. By 6:38 a.m. the next morning, that had escalated to a 511 alarm fire. By 8:23, seven specials requested. 51 Chicago firefighters injured. Damage in the millions. A.M. Saturday morning, they did feel that the fire was under control, but smoke throughout the city. On my way back from that fire, I observed another fire, this one at 18th and South Clark Street, 10:02 a.m., a five-story vacant warehouse. 23 minutes later, a 511 alarm requested at this vacant warehouse. Main concern of then Fire Chief James Keogh was that this fire would spread to other buildings in the area. The tremendous heat forced the firemen certainly to keep their distance. One firefighter injured as they were pulling away a piece of fire equipment. He got hit with a broken hose. Even some of the fire equipment showed just how hot that fire was. One of the main concerns, as we said before, was that this fire would spread to other buildings. That, in fact, it did. To the southeast, 14th and South Dearborn. As they were still fighting this fire on 18th and Clark, the walls would fall, but those embers hit the loading docks and the railroad boxcars, which escalated another extra alarm fire. These are the fire engines equipment leaving the fire on Clark Street, going to the fire at 14th and Dearborn after it was reported to them. It was just a short trip, about four or five blocks to the east. As you notice, even the civilians and fire fans were helping by this time. Fire started in the loading dock, spread to railroad boxcars. The fear once again was that those high 60 mile an hour winds would cause those embers to take even more buildings with it. So Some say this was the busiest 72 hours in the history of the Chicago Fire Department.